Miss Bryant, you mentioned before that sometimes there are problems at Driscoll House which can only be resolved through a degree of force. Would you elaborate?
Well, last night, for instance, one of the women came in, she was drunk. I tried to take the grog off her and she came at me with a broken bottle.
And what action did you take?
Nothing, I backed down.
I see. Why didn't you call the police?
Look, I don't want to get the women into trouble unless it's absolutely necessary. Usually we can sort things out just by talking about them.
Well, I strongly suggest that in future you call the police at the first sign of trouble. After all, they're trained to deal with these problems. As far as your parole is concerned, we have decided to give you one last chance to show that our faith in you has not been misplaced. But if you're accused of violent behavior at any time during your parole period, your license will be revoked immediately. Please remember that.
I will. And thanks very much.
That seat is taken. I said it's taken.
I heard you.
Then rat off.
Look.
Let's get this straight. I've got no fight with you or any of the women in here. I just want to be left alone to serve out my time with no hassles. And that's all Paddy wanted, but you put pay to that, didn't you? Well, what do you want me to do? Say I'm sorry? She just happened to walk in at the wrong time. I wasn't after her particularly. I just want a life sentence instead of the death sentence they've got waiting for me in WA.
We've got one waiting for you right here.
Look, don't bother coming there heavy with me. You're the least of my worries at this moment.
Keep out.
I want a word. Okay. Now, look, I'm warning you. I'm watching every move, so don't you try anything with Mackenzie.
Gee, Mrs. Powell. What with you keeping an eye on her and Ferguson keeping her on a leash, she's leading a charmed life.
Well, I never thought I'd get off that easily.
The parole board aren't ogres, Judy. They're just doing their job.
Yeah, well, I got a job to do too. And I think in future I'll have to handle drunks more carefully.
You're going back to Driscoll House then?
Yeah, of course. I can't see any reason why I shouldn't.
Well, you have money coming to you from America and Laurie's had a baby. I thought you might move interstate to be nearer to them.
Yeah, well, I've certainly got a lot of money, but I have no idea how I'm going to spend it, but it won't be on Queensland. I think Laurie and Jeff should be on their own, and her adoptive parents don't think much of me. I'll wait until they visit me, I think.
Well, now that we've got all that sorted out, I'll speak to the department about the careers advisor's job.
Oh, thanks, Mrs. Davidson. I'd really like that. Hey, talking about Wentworth, how's the campaign for boredom going?
Well, a member of the PRG has donated a table tennis table, so that should keep them occupied for a while. I didn't take my television set in because of their misbehaviour.
Yeah, well, you can't blame that for that.
I realise that, but I'm not going to appear to be rewarding them for misbehaving.
Yeah, it's a vicious circle, isn't it?
Well, I suppose it had to come sooner or later. But I'm surprised at you, Trixie. I thought you and me were mates.
You got no mates, Mackenzie. You're a bloody maniac.
Maybe if you're in my shoes, you'd do the same.
Like hell. Oh,
right, Maxie?
Oh, yeah, of course I'm all right. Look, you just keep your mother talking and it takes that bitch away from you. No!
Later, Maxine. Well, come on. What are you waiting for?
You'll keep.
She refuses to be examined. The sister's cleaned her up, but thinks there may be internal damage.
Then we'll call in a doctor.
I'm all right. I don't need a doctor.
Whilst you are in my charge, you will have proper medical care.
No, I don't want to see a doctor.
Who did this to you?
Answer the governor, Mackenzie.
I will not have this barbaric behavior in my prison. Tell me who the culprits are, and they will be punished. Very well. Mrs. Powell, take her to solitary for protective custody with the normal cell privileges.
No. I want to go back to the others.
As you will not tell us the names of your attackers, then we can't take the chance of them repeating their actions.
Who said it was the women?
Are you suggesting it's an officer?
Answer me. You said it, I didn't.
This is a very serious allegation, and I want to know the truth.
All right. I'm not saying anything. You can send me back to solitary if you want, but don't be surprised if it happens again.
Wait outside. What do you think?
Oh, I don't know. Smith hinted that she had some sort of arrangement with an officer, but I didn't set much store by that.
Well, we've no proof that an officer is involved, but I can't understand her wanting to go back to the women if they'd beaten her so badly.
What are we going to do with her, Barnhurst?
Out of the question. It's a low-security prison, and she's proved she is capable of breaking out. No, we'll have to let her go back with the other women. But from now on, we can't take anything for granted. We have to assume that anyone is capable of attacking her.
I told you to lay off, and I meant it. I do not need some snotty-nosed, half-baked kid doing my job for me.
Yeah, but Bea, she deserves all
she gets. I'll decide that.
Hey, Smith. You hear the news? Somebody had a go at me this arvo. Knocked me around a bit. Too bad I didn't get a good look at them. Flamin' stupid, though. Bashing me's not gonna bring Paddy back to life. Doesn't worry me, but I can handle myself. I'm gonna be around here ages yet.
You reckon?
Oh, sure. I don't scare that easily. Anyway, I just thought I'd let you know. I'm going back to my cell, if that's okay.
How do I keep an eye on her?
Oh, God, Maxie. She's as tough as nails, and I've got to share a cell with her.
So you got a watchdog?
What?
Ward. I just send her away. Heard you got a bit roughed up. How come the governor sent you back for another dose?
She wasn't going to. But there was no way I was going back to solitary.
Oh? How'd you persuade her?
I told her you did it.
You what?
Don't worry. I kept your name out of it. I just dropped a few hints. Can I help it if the governor and Mrs. Powell jump to all the wrong conclusions?
Don't you try that again, Mackenzie, because you'll regret it.